In this video, you're going to learn how to create a full-featured data grid in about 1 minute. First, we're going to look at how to bind data to the data grid. In a previous video, you learned how to add a REST API to the App Builder from a cloud service. You should review that before you start this tutorial. Then we'll take a look at the feature chooser in the grid. This allows you to select features in the grid with a simple point and click. Then we'll review the output. And then finally, we'll take a look at the source code that gets generated when you build anything in the App Builder IDE. Let's get started. I have the Create New Application dialog open, and I'm going to go ahead and create a blank layout. So we'll use that layout. By default, I just get a master view with nothing inside of the view. The first step we'll do is review that we do have our financial data from the previous video. And you'll see that all 45 fields are there, and this is 2,500 records. Now let's go to the toolbox and let's find our data grid, drag it onto the form, and let's set this to 100% width and 100% height. Now we'll go down to the grid properties. We'll select financial data, fin table, and we'll set the primary key to ID. Now I have all of the data from my REST data source in the data grid. So the data binding takes a second. Next, we'll go down to the feature chooser, which you'll see here is in the lower right-hand side of the property editor. I'm gonna click the plus sign and you'll see all of the options that I have for features on the grid. So I'm gonna go ahead and just select all of them. Summaries, resizing, pinning, moving, hiding, grouping, cell editing, row selection, row editing, row actions, toolbar, and let's do advanced filtering as well. You'll notice as I selected items, the chips showed up underneath in the feature panel, and then the grid was activated with those features. So everything's happening in real time here. The other thing to notice is that on some of the chips, you have a hyperlink. So the hyperlink allows you to set properties on the grid based on the feature that is chosen. So this is the pin columns. So for example, if I wanted to pin country, I could select country, and then by default, it gets pinned. I can do that with the toolbar and edit options on the toolbar as well. The idea is to just make it easy for you to configure the grid as much as possible. And then when you generate the code, all of that is generated with the code itself. So now that the grid has all of these options configured and it kind of looks good, all we need to do is go ahead and click preview. And now we're in the live previewer and you can see that all of my data is in the grid. I have all of my summaries. As I hover over grid rows, you'll see that the action strip is showing. So for example, we have pinned columns on the left. Country was pinned, but let's go ahead and pin a couple rows. So now I've pinned some rows. So now I have pinned groups. I can do grouping, Outlook group by. So let's go ahead and do an Outlook group by. I can collapse and expand all of these groups. I can unpin my rows if I'd like. The other thing you get in the column options kebab is a drop down with features like column pinning, grouping, sorting, column moving, and then of course filtering. So if I unselect select all, and let's just show Europe and South America, we'll click apply. And now the grid is filtered with just Europe and South America. So now if I group by region, and let's move region to the front, and we'll collapse it, you can see here I've got 409 and 421. I'll kill these groups. And let's go back. You'll see this is highlighted, which means there's something set. I'm gonna go ahead and select all and click apply. The other features that are available here, you can see column moving is enabled, sorting, so I can sort by clicking on the sort indicator, and you'll notice that the multi-column sorting is happening like so. I can also use the toolbar options, so we have pin columns here for country. I can pin category and contract, and they will stay to the left. Column hiding, same thing. We can hide various columns and show columns. And now let's take a look at what the code looks like. So I can click over here to code view, and you'll see that I have the flyout on the right-hand side. Angular is my framework that I've chosen for this particular grid. but you can see all of the column definitions are here. Here's the grid definition with all of the properties that are set based on what I chose in the feature chooser for the grid. So with a simple point and click, all of this code gets generated. All of the service data gets generated. So when you merge this code with GitHub, or if you download a zip file of the entire project, you'll have all of the code, which is accessing the data source in the cloud. So it's much more than just this. It is everything needed to run this application. So with that, in less than a minute, you configured the grid and can deliver to your users a complete experience with the App Builder in a few clicks. To get more great videos like this to learn how to use the App Builder and other Infragistics tools, click the subscribe button to get a notification when we post new content.